Good morning and welcome to Daily Prayer. Today is Tuesday, the 20th of September, and I hope this finds you well. Thank you for joining me. Do feel free to put something in the chat. As always, we use the form of prayer written by the Reverend David Adam in his book, The Rhythm of Life. We use one of the day's readings and a reflection on the reading. And on our Tuesday, the theme for our prayers is incarnation. And so we pray. Blessed are you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of the universe, yet born of the Virgin Mary. The Lord is here, his Spirit is with us. Holy God, Holy and Mighty One, Holy and Strong One, abide in us. Holy God, Holy and Incarnate One, Holy and Indwelling One, abide in us. Holy God, Holy and Life-giving One, Holy and Guiding One, abide in us. And today's psalm is Psalm 121, My Help Comes from the Lord. I lift up my eyes to the hills, from where is my help to come? My help comes from the Lord, the Maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved, and he who watches over you will not fall asleep. Behold, he who keeps watch over Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord himself watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand, so that the sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. It is he who shall keep you safe. The Lord shall watch over your going out and your coming in, from this time forth for evermore. My help comes from the Lord. And today's Bible reading comes again from the book of Acts. We pick up where we left off yesterday, Acts chapter 13, beginning at verse 44, and these early exploits of the church. Acts 13, verse 44. On the next Sabbath, almost the whole city gathered to hear the word of the Lord. When the Jews saw the crowds, they were filled with jealousy. They began to contradict what Paul was saying and heaped abuse on him. Then Paul and Barnabas answered them boldly, "We had to speak the word of God to you first. Since you reject it and do not consider yourselves worthy of eternal life, we now turn to the Gentiles. For this is what the Lord has commanded us. I have made you a light for the Gentiles, that you may bring salvation to the ends of the earth." When the Gentiles heard this, they were glad and honoured the word of the Lord and all who were appointed for eternal life believed. The word of the Lord spread through the whole region, but the Jewish leaders incited the God-fearing women of high standing and the leading men of the city. They stirred up persecution against Paul and Barnabas and expelled them from their region. So they shook the dust off their feet as a warning to them and went to Iconium. And the disciples were filled with joy and with the Holy Spirit. At Iconium, Paul and Barnabas went as usual into the Jewish synagogue. There they spoke so effectively that a great number of Jews and Greeks believed. But the Jews who refused to believe stirred up the other Gentiles and poisoned their minds against the brothers. So Paul and Barnabas spent considerable time there, speaking boldly for the Lord, who confirmed the message of his grace by enabling them to perform signs and wonders. The people of the city were divided. Some sided with the Jews, together with their leaders, to ill-treat them and stone them. But they found out about it and fled to the Lycaonian cities of Lystra and Derbe and to the surrounding country, where they continued to preach the gospel. So that's today's extract from the exciting adventures of the early church. And I'm going to read a reflection on this passage, and this week they're written for us by Reverend Christopher Herbert. Archaeologists are a subgenre of detectives. They dig and delve, find things, scrape off the mud, compare the evidence with similar pieces found nearby, and try hard not to leap to conclusions. Several teams of archaeologists have worked at Iconium over the years, including ones who have excavated coins minted in the town at roughly the time that Paul and Barnabas were there. The question for them is whether there were two dominant political groups in the town, represented by different coin-issuing mints. The polis, Greeks, and the other from the colonia, Roman veterans. If there were, then it is likely that tensions between those groups might sometimes have bubbled over. When Paul and Barnabas went to the synagogue in Iconium, It was almost foreseeable that in that small community nestled inside the larger community, their message would cause divisions. Some Jews and God-fearers sided with the apostles and became believers, while others, both Jews and God-fearers, caused such a disturbance that Paul and Barnabas had to flee for their lives. The good news was, ironically, a cause of deep division. We speak much of the role of the church as reconciler, and quite rightly. But will there be times when our message splits people apart rather than drawing them together? And if that happens, what should we do? And certainly Jesus talked about coming to bring division in families, division amongst communities. Not an easy thing to think about or consider. And so we turn to prayer and we begin with the collect, the special prayer for this week. Merciful God, your Son came to save us and bore our sins on the cross. May we trust in your mercy and know your love, rejoicing in the righteousness that is ours through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we continue in prayer, that the coming of Christ may disperse all darkness, that the birth of Christ may hallow all life, that the love of Christ may be in every heart. Lord, have mercy. That the peace of Christ may fill the world, that the descent of Christ may uplift all peoples, that the humility of Christ may teach us gentleness. Christ, have mercy. That the presence of Christ may be within us, that the power of Christ may be upon us, that the Spirit of Christ may fill us. Lord, have mercy. And we pray together as Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of Mary, born into a human family, may we know you in our homes. Bless our families and friends, our neighbours and all your people. Grant that we may rejoice that you are made flesh and dwell among us. Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Father who has shown his love for us, be with us. The Son who's come to be among us, be with us. The Spirit who fills the whole world, be with us. The Holy Three be within and without us now and evermore. Amen. Well, thank you for joining me for prayer this morning, and I do hope that you have a good day. And if you're able to, we'll be back here for prayer tomorrow at 9:45. And there is also a service in church tomorrow at 11 a.m. But until then, take care. God bless. Bye for now.